Let's talk about the M4 iMac. Across Apple's entire lineup, the M4 Mac Mini really stole the spotlight last year. I actually got one and used it as a home server, I'll link that video below. But what about the M4 iMac? It's the same body style for the last several years, unchanged since the M1 iMac, but there are some key differences that I think make the M4 iMac the perfect family computer and a great all-in-one, even if you're just looking for that one computer for your house to do it all. I've been using this as our family computer, and because of the form factor and design, I was able to stick it in a spot that not many other computers could fit, and all my kids are able to use it for things like Logic Pro, 3D printing, and the M4 chip is powerful enough where if you wanted to do video editing in Final Cut, you can do that too. I actually edited a ton of videos for this channel on the M1 MacBook Pro when that came out, and the M4 is even more powerful. But let's talk about hardware and design. Yes, it's been unchanged since the M1 iMac, but also, this looks so good. It is incredibly thin. I actually was able to fit this on an 8-inch deep desk in our family room, got an under desk tray to mount the keyboard and mouse, which now has USB-C, we'll get to that too, and I'll link that desk and keyboard tray down in the video description, but it is just an incredibly thin form factor, and guess what? Colors! Yes, Apple can do colors! It shows us with the M4 iMac, the iPhone 16, like the ultramarine, comes in an incredible blue, and if you didn't know, green is my favorite color. I mean, my entire house is actually green. And Apple, can I just say, an idea. Putting colors like these on devices with Pro in the name. Wild idea. But I would love to have iPad Pros, MacBook Pros with cool colors like this green. Because the M4 iMac is so thin, the headphone jack can go in the normal way through the back, so it's right here on the side. That comes in handy when having kids as a family computer. It has Thunderbolt ports on the back, great for connecting external SSDs. That's how I edit my videos off those external drives. And I like how the Ethernet jack is actually in the power block, so that's even less cables running up to the actual computer. And again, if this computer is going to be in a high traffic area or used by kids, the less cables to pull and accidentally tug, the better. One word on that Ethernet port, by the way, not a big deal for most, but it's a 1 gig Ethernet port. There is no 10 gigabit Ethernet option. Again, most people are not dealing with that fast speeds, but I'm weird like that and I have like 4 gigabits plus, and so can't take advantage of those. But 1 gigabit is fine for most people, even uploading and downloading 4K video. Now, one other hardware thing, which is the display. Apple actually sent me the nano-texture display on this M4 iMac, and it's the first nano-texture device I've personally had. I've seen them in the stores, but I've never used one for prolonged periods of time. Now, people swear by the nano-texture, and if you're outside or you deal with a lot of glare, it's great. Disperses the light really well. You can see the difference when I've shown my iPhone flashlight, both on my studio display, which has that glossy display, versus the nano-texture on this iMac. And that was a pretty harsh light, so even outside while I was here actually using it, nano-texture display is great. But if you're like me and you really like having the most contrast as possible and you want the most deep and rich colors possible out of your display, I do notice compared to the studio display I work on every day, you do lose some of that saturation and that contrast in those darks, those blacks, and those colors. Now, if you're not comparing it side by side, it might not be as big a deal, but if you're a photo editor, video editor, and that glossy display is what you're used to, you might want to get the glossy. And you can get either or with this iMac. You actually have the choice when you order it. Now, I might try it with an iPad in the future, because you can get nano texture on iPad Pro, but for me, I'm still a glossy display kind of guy. But speaking of video editing, the M4 chip in this new iMac is incredibly powerful. I brought my Final Cut library over, did some editing with multiple 4K video streams and multicam clips, and it doesn't miss a beat. Now, if you're going to be doing 3D animation or have a ton of plugins and effects, color grading, and you're in Premiere and After Effects, you will start seeing the M4 get a little slower. But for most people, if you're just getting into video or even in that intermediate level, doing photography, the M4 is going to be plenty powerful enough for you. And again, in a family environment or if you have multiple users on this machine, you'll be able to have many different use cases on this one computer and it keep up with everyone. My oldest son has been using Logic Pro 10 on it, making some tracks and doing some music production, learning how to do that. I use it for some Final Cut. My middle son got a 3D printer for the holidays and he's been doing 3D printing projects here on the iMac. And my youngest daughter, she's doing schoolwork and watching videos or playing PBS Kids games. So it can do all of that. Now, if you need more power, yes, maybe you should get the M4 Pro Mac Mini, or better yet, you might want to wait until WWDC this year, because we're likely going to get an M4 Ultra in the Mac Studio and Mac Pro. Now, my main machine is still an M1 Max Mac Studio, and I'm saving up because I want to upgrade to that M4 Ultra when it comes out. So if you're really looking for horsepower, maybe wait till WWDC. But again, for a general purpose computer, solo, family, or even like at the front desk of a business, M4 iMac is going to be plenty for all your needs. Plus, it now starts with 16 gigabytes of unified memory, which is great. No longer do you have to worry about starting with 8 gigabytes at that base price. This is actually the 24 gigabyte unified memory model, and you can go up to 32. So you can spec it up a little bit, and you can get a 2 terabyte SSD, which if you have multiple users, maybe multiple iCloud photo libraries on an iMac like this, you probably want to get at least the 1 terabyte, if not the 2 terabyte SSD. You can still use external SSDs like I do for storing video footage if you're doing video editing, but if you're going to have multiple users, try to get that 1 or 2 terabyte SSD. Oh, and I have to mention, we now have USB-C Magic Mouse and Magic Keyboard accessories. It's a brave new world. Now, I thought I was going to jump on those USB-C accessories the moment they launched, but honestly, the Magic Mouse is $100 if you want USB-C. The Magic Keyboard with Touch ID, you're looking at $200 for the number pad, and I use a Keychron keyboard for my main typing anyway, so I actually haven't upgraded my personal accessories yet. I still have that one lightning cable laying around, and it's fine. Plus, you can buy those accessories, the Magic Mouse and keyboard, in the colors that come with the iMac. So the nice green Magic Keyboard and Magic Mouse that came with this iMac, you can't buy that. You can only get the black or white. Which, Apple, again, just for the record, people like colors. I'd probably buy a green mouse if I could get it. But it's nice that, finally, the accessories that come with the Macs, which I think this is the only Mac that actually comes with accessories, everything else is kind of an add-on. You buy a Mac Mini, no accessories, Mac Studio, nothing. So nice that the one Mac that comes with those now have USB-C. So bottom line, who is this for? If you're looking for power, again, maybe wait for the M4 Ultra Series, or you can get the M4 Max and M4 Pro in the MacBook Pro lineup right now. But if you're looking for that family computer, I think this is ideal. I know people like the modular ability of having a different display and a computer, and that would be cheaper. You can get a base model Mac Mini, which is still a great machine, and you can save money that way. You can get an education discount Mac Mini for, I think, $500, get a really inexpensive display for like $100, and you have a great setup right there. But if you're looking for just the all-in-one setup, you just want the one computer, whether it's for the family or just for yourself. Maybe you do writing, little video editing, and photos on the side. You want a nice big 24-inch display, glossy or nano-texture, and fun colors? I think the iMac is great. Or if you have a brand or a company and you need a computer at the front desk, or you just need something that multiple users will share, I still think the M4 iMac is a great deal. Having something all-in-one, the simplicity, just a power cable to the wall, and you're good to go, I think there's something to be said about that simplicity and ease of use. I love the M4 iMac. I'm gonna have to send this back to Apple eventually, but maybe I can keep it till the M5 comes out and I buy that for the family computer. Now, real ones know, this was actually the second time I've recorded this video because the first time I did it with my Osmo Pocket 3 and I was blurry the whole time because the focus was off. So let me know how this looks because I'm recording ProRes with the Final Cut Camera app on my iPhone and I was previewing it on my iPad over here because I was not gonna be in focus again. Anyway, if you have an M4 iMac or have any questions, drop them in the comments below. And if you want to see my review on the M4 Mac Mini, which is a great machine, and I got one of those using it as a home server for Plex and some other things I can't really talk about on YouTube, check out my video on that right up here. Or if you want to keep up with all the Apple news this year, you should listen to my podcast, Primary Technology, with my friend Jason Aten. New episodes every Thursday. We cover all the Apple stuff and just all the major tech news. That's kind of our tagline, covering the tech news that matters. And I'll put that channel right up here. You can watch us every Thursday. And sometime this year, we will be reporting live from the show floor. Hopefully it's WWDC in a few months. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit that like button before you go. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.